Hello everyone. This video is on ECL, that is expected credit loss. This concept is covered under IFRS 9 or Ind AS 109, which is on financial instruments. This concept of ECL is widely used in BFSI sector, and it focuses on the quality and availability of the credit risk data. First and foremost, welcome to my channel Raise Your Acumen. This is Harshal Patil. I am a chartered accountant, and I am here to explain the concept of ECL in a simplified manner. Now before we begin, do subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon to get notified about the short and informative content which will up your acumen. Now in this video, we are going to cover these areas. Before diving into these areas, let us discuss certain concepts which will help us to better understand ECL. Let us understand what a financial instrument is. A financial instrument is any contract that gives rise to both a financial asset of one entity and a financial liability of another entity. Now these financial instruments include primary instrument, which covers receivables, payables and equity securities, and derivative instruments, which covers financial options, futures and forward, and swaps. Moving on to the area of financial assets. So this is the definition of financial asset. Now in this video, we are going to focus more on the two of the financial assets, that is loans and advances and trade receivables. Let us now discuss the recognition and measurement of financial assets. Now a financial asset is recognized in the financials when and only when the entity becomes a party to the contractual provisions of an instrument. Now, as a consequence of this rule, all contractual rights or obligations under derivatives must be recognized as assets or liabilities. Now moving on to the classification and measurement of financial asset. A financial asset must be classified under amortized cost, FVTOCI or fair value through other comprehensive income, or FVTPL, that is fair value through profit or loss. Now trade receivables which do not have a major financing element are measured at their transaction price in accordance with IFRS 15 or Ind AS 115. Now this basically means that the transaction price will be equivalent to the fair value. Now in order to classify the financial asset into amortized cost, FVTOCI or FVTPL, an entity performs tests based on its business model and contractual cash flow characteristics of the financial asset. A financial asset is classified as amortized cost when its business model is to hold financial assets and collect contractual cash flows, and the contractual cash flows arise solely from the payments of principal and interest. Now, a financial asset is classified as FVTOCI when its business model is to hold and sell financial assets, and contractual cash flows arise solely from the payments of principal and interest. Now, in any other case, a financial asset is classified as FVTPL, that is fair value through profit or loss. Let us now move on to understand as to what is credit loss. Now, credit loss is the present value of difference between the cash due to be received and expected to be received. Basically, credit loss are cash shortfalls. Now, there are two types of expected credit loss: lifetime ECL and 12-month ECL. Now, lifetime ECL are losses that result from all possible default events over a expected life of a financial instrument, whereas 12-month ECL are losses that result from all possible default events over the next 12 months of the reporting period. Let us now understand the treatment of loss allowance in the financials. Now, financial assets measured at amortized cost or FVTOCI according to their business model are subject to impairment testing. A loss allowance for any expected credit loss must be recognized in the profit and loss or OCI depending on the classification of the asset. Now, such loss allowance is measured at each reporting date. Now, the ECL model establishes three-stage impairment model, based on whether there has been a significant increase in the credit risk of the financial asset since its initial recognition. Now, these three stages determine the amount of impairment to be recognized as ECL at each reporting date. Now, under the first stage, the financial assets are performing in nature. The loss allowance is computed on 12-month ECL basis and the interest revenue is recognized on gross carrying amount. Under the second stage, the credit risk of the financial asset must have significantly increased since its initial recognition. The loss allowance now will be computed on lifetime ECL basis and the interest revenue would still be recognized on gross carrying amount. Now, under the third stage, the financial asset is credit impaired. The loss allowance is computed on lifetime ECL basis and the interest revenue will be recognized on amortized cost. Now let's take a look at the indicator for increase in the credit risk, which leads to the movement of financial asset from one stage to the other. Now let us understand how ECL is computed. Now ECL is basically the present value of the product of exposure at default, probability of default, and the loss at given default. Now exposure at default is the estimate of an exposure at a future default rate, whereas probability of default is the estimate of the likelihood of default over a given time horizon. The loss on given default is the estimate of the loss arising on default, that is, it is basically the percentage of exposure at default. Now, discounting factor is used to discount an expected loss to a present value. It is generally the effective interest rate. Now let us understand the ECL computation through an illustration. So now in this illustration, the company has taken a 10-year amortizing loan, which is of 1 crore rupees, and it estimates that the probability of default is 0.5% over the next 12 months, and the loss of given default is estimated at 25%. Now at the reporting date, there is no change in the 12-month probability of default, and there is no significant increase in credit risk since initial recognition. Now, due to all these factors, lifetime ECL is not required to be recognized. Now, from the given data, let us compute ECL. Now, the exposure at default is 1 CR. Probability of default is 0.5%, and the loss on given default is 25%. Now, if we multiply all the above, we'll get the 12-month ECL, which comes to around 1,250 rupees. Let us now discuss the simplified approach for computing ECL. Now, this simplified approach is applicable on trade receivables without significant financing component. For computing ECL under simplified approach, we follow a three-step process. At first, an entity must define a provisioning matrix. It is generally taken on the age-wise bucketing of a trade receivable based on the credit policy. Then we compute the historical default rates, which are then adjusted for forward-looking estimates. And in the third step, we compute ECL by multiplying the gross carrying amount of the trade receivable with the adjusted default rate. The current COVID-19 has caused an economic slowdown. The entities will now need to reassess the credit risk parameters, which will affect the ECL measurement. Now, these are the indicators of changes in the credit risk parameters. Now, there has been an increase in probability of default due to reduced economic activity. Contraction in economic activity and its impact on consumers have affected the value of collaterals and the business cash flows, thus adversely affecting the amount of expected loss. Now, there is an increased exposure at default as the borrowers have fully utilized undrawn limits and loan commitments. Also, the entities need to take into consideration the impact of prudential regulatory actions to sustain the economy, such as loan repayment holidays, reduction in interest rates, etc. So this was it. This is the concept behind ECL model. I hope I was able to simplify this concept. Hope you liked the video. Please do like, comment and subscribe to my channel to get informative content. Do provide your suggestions, requests and queries in the comment box below. You can connect with me on LinkedIn. I have given my profile link in the description below. Thanks for watching.